Desertification is the degradation of a productive, lush environment into dry, dry desert. Great for Mario Kart and alien planets in movies, but terrible for growing food. Hey, deserters. Thanks for tuning in to DNews today. I'm Trace. Planet Earth is a constantly shifting landscape of 8 biomes, ranging from rainforest to grassland, desert to taiga. 22,000 years ago, the Sahara was a pretty much uninhabited spot, except for the area around the Nile Valley. 10,500 years ago, monsoon rains rolled in to wet it up. Climates change, it happens, and sometimes they change hella dramatically, like when whole deserts completely shift their borders, which is happening right now. Only a few thousand years ago, the Sahara was green and lush, and now we can't even imagine that. Instead, researchers have found the Sahara's shifting sands are expanding, causing die-offs of vegetation, failure of agriculture, and increased erosion without plants to hold soil in place. But this wasn't always the case. Scientists had hypotheses that an ancient river ran through the Western Sahara, feeding the land and securing it with vegetation. Clues were left off the coast of Mauritania, where researchers found sediment resembling that of a huge river. But there was no river around, only arid sands. They called this ancient waterway the Tamaracet River, and now, according to a recent study by the Japanese Advanced Land Observing Satellite, it's real, and it was confirmed using microwave radar. If it were still there, the Tamaracet River would be the 12th largest on Earth, winding from 300 miles inland to the Mauritanian coast. As the researchers point out, climate change happens fast. In a study in Earth and Planetary Science Letters, researchers looked at 30,000 years of dust blown from Africa into the Atlantic. Over the millennia, the amount of blown dust rose and fell in lockstep with the amount of moisture on the continent. Less moisture meant more dust. More moisture meant less dust. Today, because it's so dry, the majority of the sediment in the Atlantic is from Saharan dust, and it can and does reach North America. By looking at this dust, researchers know about 6,000 years ago, the African humid period ended suddenly, coinciding with an axial change in the Earth's rotation. According to research from NASA and climate scientists, the Sahara exists in part because the Earth's spin changed, decreasing northern hemisphere monsoons and causing the Sahara Desert to grow. Vegetation died very quickly, and the third largest desert in the world took over North Africa, all in less than 300 years. In a separate study in the journal Science, one of the jet streams, which moves hot and dry air across the planet's equator, has shifted northward today, causing the tropics to expand 140 miles northward in the last 26 years, and with it, the deserts of Earth. Why? They're not sure, but they know that global warming is part of it, as is the overall rotation of our planet. In the movies, when a wizard summons a massive storm, the storm dissipates at the moment of their defeat. In reality, when we make huge changes to the Earth's climate, those changes are not felt nor easily reversed across multiple human lifespans. According to NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, the melting of Greenland ice is changing the way the Earth spins, changing the tilt of Earth's axis by 2.6 centimeters per year. And an increase in that tilt is coming on the horizon. Why is the ice melting? You only need look in the mirror. We live on a spinning top, and we are messing with the balance through climate change. So what does this all mean? To put it simply, as the distribution of ice and water on the planet changes, the Earth's axis changes in a process called precession. Thus, the sun will hit different latitudes of our planet at different intensities than it had before, drastically changing the weather systems and our overall climate. Whether it's natural or man-made, the jet stream has already shifted, causing the tropical deserts to expand into previously lush territory. We know it's done this in the past as well, but scientists don't believe that this is a wholly natural phenomenon. It's happening way too fast, and the rates are increasing. We are probably doing this. As desertification hits the American plains, South Asia, and the Mediterranean, humans feel the effects through drought, climate changes, and eventually economics. In a 2005 report about desertification from United Nations University, they state 10 to 20% of these dry lands have been negatively impacted through the loss of farmland and biodiversity. That was a decade ago. And at the time, 2.1 billion people lived in the dry lands of our planet. It's clear the deserts have and will expand. And as they continue to do so, farmland will dry, vegetation will disappear, and people will either have to move or completely alter their lifestyles. Now, if you're thinking, but Trace, the ocean is full of water, let's just use that. You can't. Julian explains why we can't just turn salt water into fresh water here.
While it sounds like a lot of cheap water, the opposite is true. The price is 80% higher than San Diego pays for treated water outside the county. And even though this plant is huge, it can only make 10% of the county's needs.
There are lots of little things that we can all do to curb climate change. Check out racingextinction.com where you can learn about things like the 5-day carbon challenge. You can challenge your friends, your family, strangers, and most importantly, yourself. There's a ton of things that you can do to make a difference out there. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Please subscribe so you get all of our videos, and we'll see you next time.